I think the take-home message is this: what we do to the oceans, we do to ourselves.
Turning to the environment, the colorful reds, orange, and blues of the Greater Barrier Reef have faded to a ghostly white color. An aerial survey shows 95% of the coral reef is severely bleached. The cause, abnormally high sea temperatures.
Although they only cover 1% of the ocean floor, coral reefs are some of the most important ecosystems. Most of you have probably heard or visited one of these underwater structures, but take it in because they're never going to last.
Good evening, Karina Cavaglio with ABC News. Secret Queensland government modelling obtained by the ABC estimates it could cost up to $16 billion to meet water quality targets over the next decade to help to save the Great Barrier Reef.
This goes from Cairns all the way to Torres Strait. It's 622 miles. 520 reefs have been examined. Only four are unaffected.
The decline is due to multiple reasons. First, the amount of pollution in our ocean. This includes every single piece of trash you've ever dropped on the ground. When you drop trash on the ground, it will almost always end up in the sea. In our ocean, there's an estimated 5 trillion tons of trash. Plastic spreads diseases and often results in plastic getting inside the bodies of marine life and spreads diseases to coral. Not only does this cause a major change in color, but there will be trash everywhere if we do not stop this major issue. Second, and the most detrimental, is climate change. The amount of CO2 we put in our atmosphere is insane, and it happens every single day. Global warming heats up our ocean, which causes coral to get stressed and then eventually bleach. They can recover, but after frequent bleaching, they will eventually die. In the Great Barrier Reef alone, up to 50% of them are already bleached. This strains all the color from our coral, which is what they are most known for. And this problem is not going to stop, it's only going to increase. This is a huge issue worldwide.
So I went on FaceTime with the CEO of Crystal Cove Conservancy to get her opinion on the matter.
So it's Alex Dunn, D-U-N-N.
Mm-hmm. And what's your background?
So my title is that I'm president and CEO of Crystal Cove Conservancy, and we're in Newport Beach, California.
Okay. First off, what's your experience with coral reefs?
So I've dedicated my career to water quality improvement, and that's mostly been on the public health side, meaning is the water safe for you and your family to swim in it? Mm-hmm. But of course, I deal a lot with marine biologists mm-hmm. who study things like coral reefs. So I have a fair amount of experience knowing what the problems are with our coral reefs and our marine ecosystems.
Okay. So would you say they're on the decline? And if yes, why do you think they're declining?
So first, I think it's important to get a sense about coral reefs and how delicate they are as a part of our marine ecosystem. So if you think about it, coral reefs are 1% of the overall Earth's
yeah.
surface and about 2% of the ocean floor. So that's a tiny, tiny percentage. And then the importance of coral reefs is that they support 25% of the marine species. Mm-hmm. So if you think about this small little kind of postage stamp and how it has 25% of the marine species living off of it, living under it as shelter, you begin to understand how important coral reefs are mm-hmm. to the marine environment, but also how important it is to our environment. So the big thing with coral reefs is they protect our coastal shores. So when we get these storms, what happens with coral reefs is they provide a buffer. And so what that means is the heavy waves or the big waves that are coming in, they provide a buffer to our coasts and help protect it from any kind of storm surge that we have.
Mm-hmm.
And so now when we think about the importance of coral reefs and then are they on the decline? Yes, they are on the decline. This has been studied for a long, long time. And it has a lot to do with climate change and what we as humans are introducing to the ocean.
Mm-hmm.
So pollution, And where that pollution is coming from is both a water quality issue, and that's a lot what I've dedicated my career to, but then also fossil fuel emissions that the ocean absorbs. So the what happens with those types of pollution that goes into the air is the ocean actually absorbs that pollution, and it's carbon dioxide. So you know that what's trending is our oceans are getting warmer. And when you have a very delicate ecosystem like coral reefs, whenever you have an increase in water temperature, it really severely stresses out the coral reef system. When you stress out an ecosystem, much like if we were stressed out as humans, you become susceptible to diseases or other even more pollution, and then you start to break down.
Yep.
So that's happening with our coral reefs, and that's what we're seeing across the globe, and that's what the concern is.
Okay. And then last question, what do you suggest should be done to help save them?
So again, a lot what I've dedicated my life to is educating people on pollution and how pollution affects the ocean. So I see it as two areas of major pollution affecting our oceans. One is water or urban runoff. Mm-hmm. So this is when it rains and all of that water picks up the pollution on the cement or in our streets, on our sidewalks. Some cities treat that water before it goes to the ocean. Other cities do not. And when you have rain falling and picking up all the pollution, all of that water then gets put into the ocean through pipes or through storm drains, you're introducing pollution into the marine environment. Mm-hmm. That has an effect on coral reefs. So if we can stop the urban runoff and the stormwater runoff from going into our oceans, that would stop the impact on the coral reefs. Second thing is from a fossil fuel standpoint, these are our car emissions and industry emissions. If we can cut down on the CO2 that goes into the environment, that's going to cut down on the pollution that goes into our oceans. Okay. And therefore a better environment for our coral reefs.
Okay. Thank you.
A world without reefs is a world where there are places without food, places where there's nowhere to live. They are critically important to coastal security and economies.
Coral reefs, if all gone, will play a major effect not only on the lives of animals, but on us as well. There are many reasons why we need to preserve them. First off, the effect on people is huge. Over 500 million people rely on these reefs for food, money, and jobs. If the reefs are gone, there will be no food for fishermen and no money for tourist guides. Millions of people will go into poverty and hunger because they have nothing to eat and no money to buy them shelter. Coral plays a major role in cancer-fighting medicines that can save the lives of our loved ones. Not only that, but the effect on the ecosystem is even worse. An estimated 1 million species live and rely on the reefs, ranging from small organisms to bigger mammals. Without them, 25% of all known marine life will be gone. Gone and wiped out completely. These amazing, beautiful structures that have been here for centuries will be gone, and we don't have a lot of time to save them. But that doesn't mean it's necessarily the end for these underwater ecosystems. There are multiple projects in effect that will help save the coral reefs. First, instead of getting rid of climate change, scientists are thinking outside of the box and making it easier for coral to adapt to it. They are making something called super coral that can survive the harsh changes of temperature in the ocean. Second are two projects that are helping get rid of pollution in our ocean. One of them is 4Ocean, which is when you buy one of their bracelets, they will take 1 pound of trash out of the ocean with the money you donated. The second project is the ocean cleanup, and it's the biggest cleanup yet. It uses technology to help get rid of plastics in our ocean, and in 5 years, they predict that they will clean up 50% of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Now, onto my solution, and it's much simpler. This is a small action you can do every day, picking up trash. If you ever see a piece of plastic laying around, pick it up and put it in the recycling. Now, we all know what they say. If you want something done, you gotta do it yourself. So,
let's go to the beach, eat, let's go get a wave, they say, what they gonna say? Have a drink? Clink? Found a Bud Light. Bad like me. It's hard to come by. The Patron? Oh, let's go get it down. The sound? Oh, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it two? Three? Leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give two.
Although it may not seem like there's a lot of trash, when you look closer, there's a bunch of small pieces of plastic that are harmful to the coral. When the trash gets caught on coral, it causes them to die. Small pieces of trash can be ingested by animals, which is very harmful. As we were walking around, we found a lot of bottle caps and wrappers that, if not picked up, would have ended up in our oceans. The scary part is, a lot of the trash is under the sand where we can't see. By the end, we collected over 100 pieces of trash off the beach. If you ever spot a piece of trash laying around, pick it up and put it in the garbage. An action as small as this can help, and if everyone does it, we will make a difference. So let's reduce the amount of CO2 we put in our atmosphere. And let's reduce the amount of pollution we put on our ground. This will help benefit our coral reefs and future generations to come.